In my last video, I made this spatula from a piece of curly maple. I said I would use the offcuts to make butter knives, and I'm a man of my word. But I want to add a little more interest to the maple, so I'm going to try incorporating some walnut into the design as well. My plan is to add some pieces of walnut along each side of the handle, so I'll start by marking a center line and resawing both the maple and walnut in half. And soon the air is filled with the toasty scent of maple and walnut. Admittedly, neither of these were my best sawing jobs, but it doesn't really matter on the walnut because I'll be gluing the outer surfaces, which are already flat. And on the maple, a little sandpaper quickly smooths things out. Then the three pieces get sandwiched together with some wood glue. When the glue is dry, I can knock off the extra walnut, then trim it down flush with the maple on all sides, so I'll have a good even surface as a starting point for carving. I recently made this butter knife from cherry, and I like the way the shape came out. It fits nicely in the hand and is well balanced, so I'm going to try to carve something that's somewhat similar to this design. Now that I have the outline marked, I'll use a saw to remove the bulk of the waste. Starting with the side profile, I'm making a series of cuts that go to the pencil line, then knocking them out with a chisel. I repeat the process to make the top-down profile. I want to cut in deep right after the walnut starts at the blade to reveal some maple at the center. With the rough shape of the butter knife beginning to take form, I'll dive into carving. After I made those saw cuts all the way to the maple, I thought I had made a terrible mistake. But once I started to get the walnut smoothed into it, it was fine. But then I decided I needed to have another spot where the maple is revealed on the handle, so I also cut in at the end of it. As I go, I'm constantly rotating the wood and looking at it from all angles, aiming to make it symmetrical all around. It was right about here that I came to the realization that I was making a bird. The little finger grip area is very thin. I think it will stand up to normal usage just fine, but it probably wouldn't take too much effort to snap this in half. Time will tell. Once the shape looks and feels good, I start sanding. I think a lot of people hate sanding, but it's one of my favorite parts. It's often tedious and tiring, but you can't beat the reward of a silky smooth piece at the end of it. I make sure to not sand the edge of the blade to a razor-thin edge, because that will just break and splinter. If it starts looking too sharp, I blunt it to a rounded edge with the sandpaper. I'm more confident in the strength of that skinny maple section now. It was subjected to a bit of force when I was carving the blade, and now again as I'm sanding, so I think it'll be just fine. Between grits, I spray it down with some water to raise the grain, let it dry, and sand it back down. I sanded this up to 3,000 grit, giving it a beautiful, satiny smooth finish. Then it's time to slather on some pure, food-grade mineral oil. And this knife is done. I wasn't exactly sure what this was going to end up looking like, but I'm pleased with it. I removed more of the walnut than I thought I would, but it still adds some nice contrast to the light-colored maple. A few pieces of scrap wood, some glue, some cutting, and you can easily make a utensil that is functional and fun. Thanks for watching.